Today we'll demonstrate it at about 2 kW or 2.1, 2.2, somewhere in that range.
Okay, well let's go ahead and start it up.
Okay. Start it up, we'll plug it in. We make sure everything looks right, there's nothing loose, nothing messed up, as near as I can perceive. Everything looks like it's supposed to be. And
it is running itself now.
Yeah, let me make sure. It's running a little faster, I think. I don't need to tell that enough. So the power must be a little bit different. But we keep it pretty close. That's supposed to be exactly, when I looked at it on the scope, it was exactly the same as what's coming out of the wall. As far as 55 volts. What happens is the power input changes. So depending on the time of day, the power comes from the power cup, it changes. The voltage actually goes up and down. Some days it'll be 115, other days it'll be 124 right here. So that's why it's a little different. Anyway, run it down. Light up some lights, unless you have any other questions.
Nope, I think that's good. I didn't hear any slowdown of the motor.
I heard a slight one. On the third bulb and the fourth and fifth bulb, it was way back. It was at least sound like anything. That's what it wasn't a slowdown. It was actually a mellowing out, a little smoother. It sounded a little smoother. It went back to video and listened to the video. I heard a slight one. Maybe I'm going to have
to. Okay, I'm going to basically just pan across the machine here.
Yeah. of focusing on the back page. We're focusing in on getting these things guys produced.
So what we've got here is a self-running generator. It's basically providing over 2,000 watts. This will run indefinitely without fuel.
Meaning it runs until the parts run out, wear out. And when you say indefinitely, yeah, that's true. It means indefinitely, but indefinitely means basically until the parts wear out.
For instance, moving parts would wear out.
Moving parts and solid state parts wear out. Televisions go bad, computers go bad, they're all solid state, they're still go bad. There's still parts wear out. Cell phones go bad, you know, different things.
Okay. So really the really special part of this technology is the rotating generator in this machine. And the you might talk just a little bit about why that's special and what makes it that your ministry has been able to make such a small generator put out this amount of power.
Why it's special?
Yeah, why it's special and what the technology is that's actually...
A little bit about the technology. Okay, basically there's many types of subatomic particles. And it's the way you make those particles and the way you establish them as to whether or not you get over the immunity. And there's over 100 types of subatomic particles defined now. And everybody used to think that the only thing that flowed through wires was electrons. But that's not true. Nowadays, quantum physics realizes that many types of subatomic particles, and depending on what those particles are, which ones you have, in which places, and which vibrations you have, and those frequencies in which places, and what the power levels are, and how they're arranged with each other, and where the standing fields are, that all has to do with how it works. If you get it right, you know, basically by different combinations of those things, you can do anything you can imagine, including space travel and everything else, teleportation and all that. But basically, the simplest, one of the simplest ones would make an energy, and that's what we're focusing in on here.
Okay. And with this device, that's a standard variable transformer that you adjust the speed of the motor with.
Yeah, that's a standard motor, too.
Standard motor, standard belt drive, and a standard load of regular incandescent light bulbs. So the real technology is in the generator and how it's built and how it works.